is the question. This is the question asked in day 2020. Okay, day 2020 they asked. So let us discuss this question. Day 2020 question. F of x is the function is given x, which is in between of 0 to half, and x is equal to half. F of x is half. F of x is in between of half and 1. This is 1 minus x. This is the function f of x defined. F of x is defined from 0 to half is x. X is equal to half. Y is half. X is in between of half and 1. That is 1 minus x. G of x is given x minus half whole square. Then find the area bounded by f of x and g of x from x is equal to half and x is equal to root 3 by 2 is 1. This is day 2020 question in January month, 9th day, shift 2. I think shift 1 or 2, I don't know. Let us see how to solve this question. Let us draw the diagram of the f of x and g of x in that. First of all, what we do here, let us draw the diagram of this. Now, let us see here, from 0 to half, what is saying here? X value from 0 to half, let us consider this is a half. 0 to half, the value of the function is f of x. Means this is going through origin. And this is half, that is what we say. And then this x is half, then y is half. Means x is half, then y is half, this is the point we say. If x is 1 and half, means half to 1 in between, then the function is 1 minus x. 1 minus x line. 1 minus x line will be passes through like this. Just you check it out, you will get the answer. You just draw the diagram, you will get it. X is equal to half, will go by that way. Okay, hope you understand. I think little bit, the diagram will be same. Little bit, this will come here, then it just goes like that. What I want to say here, half, the scale I took, na? If this length, if I take half, here is that length half. So here is comes this point is here, right? So x is equal to 1, this is the point. And if I take this is a half length, and this length will be 1, right? This length will be 1, and this is passes through like this. So what just I want to say here, this is the line you have, graph. So what is the graph of this line? This line graph is 1 minus x, y is equal to 1 minus x, this is the graph of the line. If you have doubt, do one thing. Whenever you have a doubt, you just take x and y values, see if x is 0 and y is 0, see if x is 0, y is 1. So x is 0, y is 1, this is the point is 1. And if y is 0, then x is equal to how much? 1. X is equal to 1, this is the point is coming. So these two lines is passing through like this. This is a half, it studies and goes this way. So you are getting this is the line is 1 minus x is equal to y. And this is what is you got from 0 to half, this is y is equal to x line. And half is a half, this is the point itself. F of x graph is done. Now g of x graph, g of x is saying that x minus half whole square. This g of x is nothing but y, right? Y is equal to x minus 1 whole square. This is y is equal to parabola. Y is equal to x squared time. Y is equal to x squared. But half, the parabola is shifting half. Here shifting half. Graphical representation. In that here, it is shifting half. Means at half, y is equal to x minus half whole square. The zero of this is x is equal to half. The parabola is upwards parabola because the rate, the leading coefficient is positive. So upwards parabola. Is from half. So the zeros of this one is half. So the parabola is that it is touching x axis at half and moving here like this. This is the parabola itself. It's asking that what is the area bounded by x is equal to half line, and this intersecting point is, the intersecting point of this is x is equal to root 3 by 2. You just find out the intersecting point. Now you will find out you have y is equal to this, you have this is y is equal to what? Y is equal to x minus half whole square, and just equate this both, means x minus half whole square should equate to 1 minus x from these both, these both are equated, you will get x value root 3 by 2 and half. X value will get root 3 by 2, okay? You will get x is equal to root 3 by 2. So he is asking that is only the area bounded by this is how much? This is the question he asked. So area in between them is how much? This is the question he is asked. So you have to find the area here. You need to find this area. This area you have to find. This is the area he is asking to find. Okay. Bounded by this line, this x equal to between where to where? Half 2 to 3 by 2. This area is asking. This area is asking. Okay, this area I have to find. So you just look at here, this one is a trapezium. This one is a trapezium. This is a trapezium. Okay, this is a trapezium. You want to find the area? Let us see here. Area is equal to area of the trapezium. Area of the trapezium, let us consider this is A point, B point, C point, D point. So area of the trapezium A, B, C, D. Okay, this area. So you will get the whole area. From that you have to subtract half to root 3 by 2. Half to root 3 by 2. And this area under this curve should be subtracted. Means what is the area should be subtracted? X minus half whole square dx should be subtracted. This is your answer. This is the way to find here. So this one will be very easy. This is you can find out. Let's see the steps. I will find it here. Area of the trapezium formed by A is half into D into A plus B. D means what here? Distance between the parallel lines. A means this is the length of one parallel line, length of another parallel line. That is what? Minus integration. Half to, this point is half. Half to integration. Half to root 3 by 2. The curve is under this curve. This area will be coming how? This area will be coming by this area. This is x minus half whole square dx. Let's see here the area of this trapezium. How much you get here? Half into this. D is this one. D is this one. This is the distance. This length is root 3 by 2. This length is 1 by 2. The distance will be root 3 by 2 minus half. Means this minus, see here. From here to here root 3 by 2. From here to here half. Then from here to here will be what? Root 3 by 2 minus half will be this length. So this is root 3 by 2 minus half. Okay, that is the DI. Now what I have to get this point and this point. This point is half comma half. Half comma half. This is the already in the graph you have seen. So this one is half. Plus B. B means what? This length. This length is B. This length is B. This length how much you get here? If x is root 3 by 2. If x is root 3 by 2. Substitute in this. In this. What I am going to get here? Y is equal to. X is equal to root 3 by 2. Na? X is what? How much? X is equal to root 3 by 2. Substitute in this line. Or this. Line is for. What was the line? 1 minus x is equal to y. Line is what? 1 minus x is equal to y. This line is intersecting here. So 1 minus this x is what here? X value is root 3. Root 3 by 2. 1 minus root 3 by 2 is equal to y. So what is the y value? Y value will be 2 if you do LCM. 2 root 3. 2 minus root 3 by 2 is the y value. Then the y value is 2 minus root 3 by 2. 2 LCM do it, you get the y value. So this length is 2 minus root 3 by 2. This is the area of trapezium. So area of trapezium is half into D into A plus D. This is D because x is root 3 by 2. Substitute in this length, y will get. So you are going to get y value here 1 minus root 3 by 2. That is 2 minus root 3 by 2. So this is the area of trapezium and you have to integrate this point. Minus you have to integrate this one. What is the integration of x square? X square integration is minus 1 by 2 whole power 3. 2 plus 3 upon 3, right? And you have to substitute the limits. What are the limits? You have root 3 by 2 and 1 by 2. So this step is comes here. Actually, the steps comes here. What I want to say here, the step is the answer will be what here? This is the area of trapezium minus. This is what you get, x minus 1 by 2 to the power of 3 divided by 3. This is the integration. And now we will substitute root 3 by 2 and 1 by 2 in this. Just substitute this thing and simplify, you will get the answer. This is JEE 2020, this is question is asked. Hope you understand, simplify yourself. See, this is the question. Consider the following. R1 is equal to x comma y. X comma y, x is in between 0 to 1 and y is in between 0 to 1. R2 is x comma y such that x square plus y square is less than or equal to 4 by 3. R1 intersection R2 can be expressed like this. Find the values of A and B. So the question is find the values of A and B. What is the value? 1 point more than 1 point something. 2 square is 4, 4 by 1 point something, but more than 1. So more than 1 point if I take here, more than 1 point if I take here, more than 1. This is the 1 point and this is 1. More than 1 is here. More than 1 is here. Suppose you are taking and draw the circle of this one. Draw the circle of this one. So you get the shape of this one. So you can get the actually exactly I did not draw properly circle. So actually if you draw this one, you get this shape. But it is required in the first quadrant. Let us draw the first quadrant only itself. So here I actually what I want to say here from one as taking as this one is what we can say as one is here, little bit this is one, and this is one, and this one little I take it more. Okay. I do proper diagram. Okay, I'll do the proper diagram. So this is what you have. Okay, I'll just take the scale proper. Let us take this is 1 unit. Okay, this is take 1 unit. Okay, the same thing I have to take here also. Same thing. This distance I have to take here also. Let us take this is 1. Okay. So this is x is equal to 0 line. This is x is equal to 1 line. This is equal y is equal to 0 line. This is y is equal to 0. And this is y is equal to 1 line. Okay, this is y is equal to 1 line. So the region was this. And this one is 2 by 3, somewhat here, little bit. So let us take in this is a radius and draw the circle, you get like this. You get like this circle area. So this is the circle you have, but somewhat it will come inside, not outside. It won't go outside. So what was it asking here? The question is here, R1 and R2, both are intersect. R1 intersection R2 is expressed like this, what is the A and B values. So intersection of these both, okay, the intersection of these both in the first quadrant we asked, x is equal to in between these, okay, in this between. So what I have to write here, you need to find the area in between them, right? You have to find the area in between them. Exactly, this is the diagram, okay, this is the diagram we will get. So this is x is equal to 0 and this is x is equal to 1, this is y is equal to 1, this is y is equal to 0. And greater than more and you will get the circle shape like this, circle shape. He is saying that, what he is saying here, consider R1 is this one, R2 is this one, and both less than R equal to means circle inside this, means all together is asking to find the area of this one. I tell you, this is the area is asking to find, where to where, x is equal to 0 to 1, okay, 0 to 1, this place. Till x is equal to 0 to 1, here this area, all combined area, because 0 to 1 should be there, 0 to 1 upper part should be there, and this circle should be there. All these three things are in this place, they are intersecting. Hope you understand what I said. So this is the place, x is equal to 0 is this place, x is equal to 1 means these are the place, y is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, this is the place inside. And this circle inside place. So this is the intersecting point. Means this highlighted one. This is the area is asking. I'll tell you, this is the area is asking to find. Okay. Is asking to find this area. Okay. Now, before that, you have to find the intersecting point of this. Y is equal to 1. Y is equal to 1 if I meet with this. Y is equal to 1 if I meet with this circle. So what I get here? X square plus 1 is less than R equal to 4 by 3. Equal to you take it. X square is less than, x square is equal to 4 by 3 minus 1. X square is equal to 4 minus 3, 1 by 3. So x will be 1 by 3. This value will be x is equal to 1 by 3. How you got here? Because the value of y is 1, substituting in this circle, then I am getting x is equal to 1 by 3. Means only this area is equal. Plus or minus I get. But I don't want negative numbers, negative things. Yes, So I need to get this area. This area is 1 by root 3 to 1. So 1 by root 3 to 1. And under this area, under which curve it is there? Under which curve? Under this curve. This is x square plus y square equal to this. So I have to find integration of this. So y square will be how much? 4 by 3 minus x square. 4 by 3 minus x square dx. And you have square, so you get square root. Square root of 4 by 3 minus x square dx. So area of the rectangle is formula is length into breadth. This is 1 unit, this is 1 by 3 units. So area of this rectangle will be, area of rectangle will be length is 1, breadth is 1 by root 3. And plus integration 1 by root 3 to 1, 1 by root 3 to 1 under root of 4 by 3 minus x square dx. So these type of things already we have done. This one you can apply a square minus x square formula. You can simplify and that you can compare with this. Okay, hope you understand. So here after applying this formula, you just see here after applying this formula a square minus x square integration. I am just giving for your sake here, that is you get 1 by root 3, the integration formula a square minus x square apply, x by 2 under root of a square minus x square plus a, you will get here a by 3 sine inverse, so you have the formula, right, sine inverse x by a. So according to this, you apply the formula here, you substitute the formula. After that, you can substitute 1 and 1 by root 3 here in this. So after substituting that, if you simplify, you get 3 root 3 plus 5 by 9. If you compare this both, a value will be 3, b value will be 1. So the answer is a is equal to 3, b is equal to 1. This is work for you.